What's up, everyone? Welcome back to another MoGraph Mindset tutorial. I'm going to share a really useful expression that I used in this MoGRT to autoscale an image to text. To follow along, you can download the MoGRTs in the description. Double-click the vertical one and it'll automatically launch AE. Extract the file and it'll open up the project. From here, you have full access to edit everything included in the MoGRT. This text layer right here in the bottom left has this tape background that autoscales to the text. If I change this text out, the tape will grow with it, and we can even adjust the padding. How is this set up? The tape layer is this orange layer right here. I'm going to solo that and the text layer so we can just focus on these two. And I've got a few expressions on this layer. The scale expression looks intimidating, but we'll rebuild it from scratch, and I'll explain every step of the way. Let me import my tape layer again, and I'll turn off this old one. And I want to autoscale it to this text layer, right? First of all, let's get it in the right area. And let's scale it down so that optically it fits our text. And I'll delete the old one and then shy all of our layers except for the ones that we're working with so we have a clean timeline. Our scale is percentage based, meaning we're not going to see the actual pixel dimensions that this is taking up in our composition. So I've set some rulers to see the edges of our text. What you could do is measure from one ruler to the next to figure out the distance and therefore the size of our text layer. However, a better way to measure things is actually just to right click, go to transform scale, and change units from percentage of source or composition to pixels. And this will report the actual pixel dimensions of a layer's bounding box. So the text layer is 234 by 26 pixels. We can do the same for our scaled tape layer. So transform scale, and we can see that this is currently taking up 308 by 97 pixels. And you can see our scale values here. So with that info, I'm going to start building this out. So we're going to add an expression to our scale layer, and we know we're going to need a few values. The first thing we're going to need is our target layer. This is the layer that we want to autoscale to. So I'll make a variable for that and just pick whip our text layer. Now we need our target width, which is just the target layer source rect at time dot width. And that is going to give us that 234 pixel value. We need our target height. So same thing for the target height, source rect at time dot height. And if we output target width and target height, that's giving us 234 by 26. But now our tape layer is stretching 234% on the X and 26% on the Y. Because the scale property is percentage based, not pixel based, we need to convert this tape layer's size in pixels to our target text layer size in pixels. So let's create some new variables for this width, and we'll say this layer dot width, and var this height, and this layer dot height. And what does that give us? That gives us 710 and 319. Hold up. When we measured this layer before, it showed us 308 by 97. Well, measuring this layer dot width or this layer dot height gives us the original dimensions of the layer before any transform effects like scale are applied. 710 and 319 is the original pixel size of our tape layer PNG. All right, so I'm just going to add some comments here to remember our values. So we had 710, 319, and for our target width, we had 234 and 26. I'm just adding comments to remember our pixel values. Now that we have the pixel dimensions of our text layer and our tape layer, we really just have to do some basic math. So let's say that X equals target width over this width, and Y equals target height over this height, and output that. What does that give us? It looks like 0.3 on the X and 0.1 on the Y. Let's do this math ourselves. So our target width of 234 divided by this width of 710 gives us 0.3295. And our target height of 26 divided by 319 gives us 0.0815. If you multiply these by 100, then you would have 32.95% and 8.15%. So I'll multiply these both by 100, and we're getting about those values, 33 and 8.4. Our tape layer is stretching 33% on the X and 8.4% on the Y. And now it looks like it's fitting to our text layer. I'm gonna add two sliders with value 100 and rename them to padding X and padding Y. Pick whip to replace the hard-coded 100 value with our new sliders. Now we can increase the ratio here. And we know that if we leave it at 100, then it'll fit perfectly versus we can say it's 50% or 200%. So the problem is if you move your text layer, your tape layer is not going to follow. And likewise, if you add lines, then your tape layer is going to grow from the wrong place. So our tape layer's anchor point is directly in the center. So for our text layer, we want to force that anchor point to be directly in the center of that layer also. So let's open up its anchor point property and add a simple expression. So left top width height equals this layer dot source rect at time. And that will pull the left top width and height values from this layer. And then to center it, we just say left plus width over 2 and top plus height over 2. And that's how you can auto center an anchor point. Now when you change the text, your anchor point will always stay centered in that text layer. So to get the tape to follow it, you can just parent it. However, same deal, where it's not locking to that anchor point position. So all we have to do is open up our position property, pick whip the position to the anchor point, and voila. Now you can move this around to your heart's content, change out the text, and use our padding X and Y sliders, and everything will auto-scale and reposition automatically. I'm gonna close that up. So to recap, here's our key formula. You just need to divide your target pixel size over your current pixel size and multiply it by 100. If you keep that principle in mind, you'll be able to auto-scale any layer to anything else. You can auto-scale graphic layers to text layers, layers to the bounds of a composition, layers to masks and shapes, etc. This is a really useful technique and I haven't seen it covered before. Hope you guys find this useful. Feel free to dig into the project. I think it's a cool one, and you'll probably learn something if you try to break it apart and rebuild things yourself. Hope you enjoyed. Catch you in the next one.